Now, if Taiwan is going to be first in the world at anything, I would rather it be for food or quality of people named Leslie. And we did find out we were in fact number one at something, but it's not for either of those things, not even close. We were number one in the world for Asian Flush.
The Asian flush isn't just a physical response to drinking alcohol, it's an enzyme deficiency. People who lack the ALDH2 enzyme cannot metabolize alcohol. This results in flushed faces, respiratory problems, nausea, vomiting, and possibly diseases. Nearly half of the people in Taiwan have this deficiency.
Many Asians have this enzyme deficiency. They have a hard time metabolizing alcohol, so they often don't feel well after drinking.
People who lack the ALDH2 enzyme have a 50 times higher risk for mouth, throat, and esophageal cancers. A Stanford study found that Taiwan ranks top in the world for this enzyme deficiency. It advised these people to avoid alcohol altogether. According to the World Health Organization, in 2016, over 3 million people died from alcohol-related causes. 29% was related to drunk driving or violence. The rest were due to cancer and cardiovascular or other alcohol-induced diseases. Even low-level consumers of alcohol were found to have a 1.26 times higher chance of getting cancer than those who don't drink at all. So it is a good idea to think before you drink, especially if you get the Asian flush.
All right, guys, so tell me what you think about that story.
Okay, in a word, sober. I think it was sobering, and those people with Asian flush should stay sober.
All right, my word, red-faced. You know, don't feel red-faced if you get red-faced when you drink. But actually, this is also a reference to me. I feel kind of red-faced talking about Asian flush, being the white guy in the room. So I'll stop there.